Hey folks, welcome back to another video. And today it's about this plugin. It's called Rhythmic by Acusonus. And it's a beat repeater combined with an extractor. It tries to extract some individual parts from your drum loops. So the kick drums and the snare drums and the hi-hats, and puts it into different boxes at the bottom here automatically. You can also import different drum loops. For instance, when you have a kick loop and a snare loop and a hi-hat loop separately, you can put it for yourself into the boxes here below and then start to mangle around with some of the beat repeater functions. So also the website has a lot of bold claims for this plugin and also the buzzword AI. So I try to download the try version here to see what's behind it. And I'm starting here with a pretty basic 80s drum loop. Pretty generic, but in this case, we will keep track of what's actually happening. So we track it here into the top area, and there you have the option to extract the stems or just import. Just import, there will be only one box with the combined drum loop, the original drum loop. When we go for extract stems, it tries to extract the kick drums and the snare drums and the hi-hats. So we will do this. So now you have the kick drums here and snares here, and we have the hi-hats in this box. And from now on, it's more or less like an standard beat repeater, if you so will. You have beat repeater for the kick, the snares and the hi-hat separately, and can turn and twist it here. And this is maybe the first bug. When you change the parameters, nothing happens. You have to actually press play. So as you can see, we rearranged some of the kick drums, we added some reverb to some of the kick drums, and we used silence function where you can mute some parts of the kick pattern. And you can also, of course, apply this to the snares and to the hi-hats separately. So let's do this. You can hear this works, but you also can hear some phase issues because it's not actually recognizing the individual instruments. That's what I think. It goes straight for the frequency layers. So it extracts the low end and the middle part and the top end, and not separates really between the instruments. So for instance, when we solo in here the snare drum or the middle part, then we can still hear some of the kicks in the middle part, the top end of the kick drum. Which is okay, but when you mangle around with the beat repeater, sometimes you have the top end of the kick there and the kick drum, the bottom end of the kick there, and then you have some issues with the layering. And sometimes this is okay, but if you're looking for a plugin to create alternative patterns from your kick from your drum loops, then maybe this is not the real option. This is maybe more for when you create some fill-ins or breakdowns in your static, from your static drum loops. And there's also a beat assistant here, which claims it has EQ. I think that's the AI part of the plugin. And it claims you can rearrange your drum loops, but what's actually happening, I think it's just some randomization. It sounds pretty randomized to my ears at least. So that's nothing, that's not the pattern I want to have as a main loop in my track or in my song. That's maybe more for a breakdown in a live environment when I want to change quickly at some part, at some point in time in my life set, some of my drum loops. But that's nothing I want to have to run all the time in my drum, in my song. It also sounds pretty straight on the grid, and I'm missing some groove options where you can nudge around some of the patterns. So it all sounds pretty techno, straight into your face, straight on the grid. So there's no no groove option. That's something I miss heavily on this plugin, and also something where you can just push a button and have a randomized a new pattern for your drum loop, and that's playing all the time. But in this case here, you have a drum loop changing every second, so it's a bit. So this is basically something I would bounce to have a static new pattern for my drum loop. Also, this is maybe more interesting when you have more complex drum loops or percussion loops, maybe. This could be more interesting. So I would say the Pete extractor or the extractor needs some work to actually get rid of the top end from the kicks in the middle part. And also the beat repeater needs some work where you have some groove options. At least that would be my feedback for this plugin. I think it's a good idea to have something like this. It's also resizable from the interface, which is nice, but there needs to be some aspect ratio here to actually make use of this, and it's also crashing sometimes when you resize it. So this plugin came out today, so there are obviously a lot of bugs still in it, which is okay, and I think the idea is great, but it needs some work. So thanks for watching, and I see you in the next video. Bye.